In the day's other news, California announced that it will lift all its COVID-19 restrictions on June 15th if hospitalizations remain low and if there's sufficient vaccine supply. But its mask mandate will remain in effect. Meanwhile, Indiana ended its statewide mask order, although businesses can still require customers to wear them. And a rare sight in Arlington, Texas last night, a sellout crowd packed in to watch the Texas Rangers home opener, the largest in-person audience for a Major League Baseball game since the pandemic began. In the Derek Chauvin trial, much of today's questioning centered around the crisis intervention training that he had received. The prosecution asked a Minneapolis police lieutenant who teaches use of force techniques whether Chauvin used proper tactics when kneeling on George Floyd's neck for more than 9 minutes.
We don't train leg-neck restraints with the officers in service. And as far as my knowledge, we never have.
Say, for example, the subject was under control and handcuffed, would this be authorized?
I would say no.
Another Minneapolis police officer confirmed that Chauvin had CPR certification. The department's policy required him to begin administering aid to Floyd before paramedics arrived, which he did not do. A Navy medic shot two U.S. sailors at a military facility in Frederick, Maryland today before fleeing to nearby Fort Detrick Army Base where he was assigned. The suspect was later shot and killed by base police. The two people he shot remain in critical condition. The gunman's motive is still unclear. The U.S. and Iran began indirect talks today to discuss possible U.S. re-entry into the 2015 Iran nuclear deal. In Vienna, U.S. and Iranian envoys held closed-door meetings alongside officials from five nations who are still signed on to the deal. Former President Trump pulled the U.S. out of the agreement in 2018 and reimposed sanctions on Tehran. At least 100 civilians have been killed in border clashes in Ethiopia's north and eastern region since Friday. Local officials blamed the bloodshed on Somali regional forces. All this comes as Ethiopia prepares to hold national elections in June. In Israel, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has been tasked with forming a new government, even as he personally faces corruption charges. Israel's President Reuven Rivlin made the announcement today in Jerusalem and addressed concerns about Netanyahu being on trial.
I know very well the position held by many, that the president should not give the role to a candidate that is facing criminal charges. But according to the law and the decision of the courts, a prime minister can continue in his role even when he is facing charges. That's the decision of the Supreme Court after it was asked to rule on the matter.
Today's move comes after Israel had its fourth inconclusive election in 2 years. Netanyahu now has up to 6 weeks to form a governing coalition. Back in this country, Arkansas has become the first state in the nation to ban gender-affirming medical treatment for transgender youth. Republican Governor Asa Hutchinson vetoed the bill yesterday, but today, the state's Republican-controlled House and Senate voted to override his veto. On Wall Street today, stocks fell from record levels. The Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 97 points to close at 33,430. The NASDAQ fell 7 points, and the S&P 500 shed 4. Florida Democratic Representative Alcee Hastings has died of pancreatic cancer. He began his career as a civil rights lawyer and was Florida's first black federal judge before being impeached and removed for accepting bribes. Hastings was elected to 15 terms in Congress and became the longest serving member of Florida's congressional delegation. Alcee Hastings was 84 years old. And Baylor University men's basketball team has won its first ever national championship. Baylor ended Gonzaga's undefeated season, prevailing in an 86-70 blowout that sent Baylor's campus into a frenzy. We'll talk to the coach of the women's NCAA championship team, Stanford, later in the program. Still to come on the NewsHour, more businesses in Georgia speak out against the controversial new voting law. Several pro football players of color claim they were penalized in the NFL concussion settlement. how turning to the performing arts can help ease political divides, plus much more.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington, and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.